How can you use a formal camera survey to collect some information to really help improve the hunting on your property? That's the topic of today's Land Beat. Trail cameras are a ton of fun. Hunters across the Whitetails Range use them to scout for deer, to collect information, to see what bucks are in the area. But with a little bit of help, we actually can take another step and conduct a formal camera survey of the deer using a property to really increase the opportunity that we have from a hunting standpoint to assess numbers, age structure, quality of bucks on an area, but more importantly, the number of does that we should be shooting to ensure that we are balancing the deer herd with available food and cover and maximizing the opportunity for those bucks to grow every bit as big of antlers and body size, as well as those does to produce as much milk for those developing fawns. What we're gonna do is we have the ability to set cameras out on a grid pattern across your property. Essentially use one camera for every 50 to 100 acres. And there's two time periods of the year. We can do a formal survey late summer at the end of the growing season from an antler standpoint when those antlers are right at the end of velvet or just getting out of velvet, or we can do it again in the winter. The reason for these time periods is we wanna make sure that we can uniquely identify each of the different bucks that are there. Now, it's a very simple process to be able to do this, and we have step-by-step instructions on our website at deerassociation.com to walk you through this whole thing. In short, though, essentially, we're going to run a camera survey for at least 2 weeks, collect pictures of all these deer, count the numbers of different bucks, does, and fawns that we get, and then based on the number of different bucks we have, there's a way that we can figure out how many different does we have in all those pictures and how many different fawns we have, come up with a total number. So, that step-by-step instructions I described will walk you through that process very simple. In addition to, you are going to learn a whole bunch about how deer use your property, size of the deer herd, quality of the deer herd, age structure, etc. So there's a lot of other things that we will get. Now, I have been doing formal camera surveys on our Pennsylvania farm for the past 20 years, and it has really opened my eyes as a deer manager to numbers of does that we should be shooting. So for example, there are some years when the deer herd is really climbing that we have shot anywhere between 20 and 30 adult does in one hunting season. There are other years where we have got that deer herd about in balance with available food. Maybe we weren't recruiting a lot of fawns and we have only shot 5 or 10 does. That's a big difference on the same property. What has helped us to continue to be successful and improve our program? It's these trail cameras and not just using it for scouting, but doing this formal survey. So let me tell you some of the things that I have gotten from this. Once you do this and look at these pictures and run through the survey, you get things like an estimated fawn recruitment rate. How many fawns are you bringing into the system in the fall? You know, we all know that the predators are taking more fawns in many areas than they have in the past, but are they really impacting you where you are or not? Just because you hear coyotes or see a bear doesn't mean they're negatively impacting that program. This survey will help you decide whether, yeah, they are taking some or they're taking way too many. Also, it lets us know, hey, what is the age structure of the buck population here? If you're trying to raise older bucks, this lets you estimate how many 1-year-old, 2-year-old, 3-year-old, and older bucks you have. And hopefully over time, that percentage of older bucks continues to increase. Lets you know what you're doing as a manager is helping. If you think, yeah, we're harvesting based on an age restriction or harvesting based on some type of antler restriction, you ought to see an increase in that age structure if that's your goal. If that's happening, great. If not, you'll know whatever you're choosing to use as your harvest rate really isn't working. It's time to try something else. Or maybe you're not moving older bucks, so it's time to go ahead and talk to your neighbors and try to get them on the same page to also protect some of these younger deer. So either way, this lets you know if what you are doing, is it working or not? And it's not just, yeah, I think, or no, I don't. This documents, it's very clear, yes or no. If the answer is yes, that is great. If the answer is no, hey, we just need to change something up to get to where we need to be. It lets us know how many does are on the property, and this is arguably one of the most important aspects of this from a management program, because every single year going into our hunting season, I will use this camera survey data and I will calculate a target doe harvest for our property. So all the friends, all the family, all the guests, everybody that I bring into our property each year, they know exactly how many does we're gonna shoot before day one ever gets here. And this is great because how many times have you got into deer season and all of a sudden you're not seeing as many deer? So then people say, ooh, must be the deer herd is down. We're going to back off doe harvest. Well, as educated viewers here, you know that as we enter the woods, our behavior and our activity influences deer behavior. So suddenly they're just not as active. They're harder to see. This allows you to collect information on actual numbers of deer that are there before the deer season so that you can calculate a target doe harvest before we negatively impact deer behavior and make them want to spend more time moving at night. So we go into the deer season saying we're going to kill 8 to 10 does this year, or no, we need to try to shoot, you know, 18 to 20 does, whatever the case is. And then everybody that hunts that property through the course of the year has a chance to try to help meet that goal. That is the single best way to achieve what you want from a management standpoint, and to make sure that you are producing as healthy deer as possible, which then certainly helps us from the hunting end. So if you want to learn how to do a little more than just scouting with these, this very simple process, check out the information that we have. Follow that, be able to use that this summer or maybe this winter, and you will take your deer management program to the next level.